We first see Zam Wessel's speeder in the chase on Coruscant, where Obi-Wan and Anakin are trying to find out who's been killing people. When I was first given the designs for what became Zam Wessel's speeder, again, we didn't have the script yet. It was early on in the production of Episode 2, and that particular speeder was intended for the Kaminos. In fact, there was a piece of artwork that showed a Kamino kind of with his head tucked down low and forward to try and fit into the speeder, which didn't really seem to work, I think, for him, and probably just as well that they didn't end up using them. But it was interesting that it got repurposed for another character later on. Originally, you couldn't get inside the model. I carved it from a wooden block, and then they came back to it and said, oh, we have an interior we want to put into it. So I had a design for an interior that I had to then fit inside of this model. So I had to cut the model open and figure out how to put an interior inside of it.
I mean, what you could do is round this off.
Okay, run it off this way.
Run it off that way, mm-hmm. And then make this window continue all the way up to this, so it's like one bubble.
I think the look was nice, because it had a certain amount of menace to it, I think, that worked for her character. Because at that point of the film, you didn't know whether it was a man or a woman or some sort of other alien. And so to have the ships or look like the character's persona, I think really helps in the film.